One place Drew knows he can source quality, utilitarian items are places with an industrial heritage. Drew and T are traveling just over 100 miles east to visit a unique business that's been operating for over a century.
T, we're up in the Peak District and we're going to William Lennon Boots. And these guys have been at this for over 100 years. It's a family business. All sorts of different things you can get from these places. And they're always pretty damn good. Now, this place, being here for 100 years, could yield some really good pieces because they're a factory as well.
You'll be all right if you talk about their industry with them today, because you're used to talking cobblers, aren't you?
Aiming to clear some space among some of the 100-year-old equipment, Dan and Libby think they've got just what Drew could be looking for, so want to kick off in the boot workshop.
Oh, blimey, look at this. It doesn't look like anything's changed.
Not much has.
How long's it been here?
We've been here since 1904.
Oh, I love it.
The only one left in the world still doing
traditional
this sort of thing.
Yeah. Really? The only one in the world?
Yeah.
This factory looks like it's never been touched. So, for me, it's a perfect place to come to look for stock. But the most important thing is they've never moved. So, it started in this building and it's still in this building. So, traditionally, places like this, very hard to find, but extremely good for me to buy from. Have you got loads of these?
I think we've only got two.
Do you want to sell them?
We've probably got one for sale. That one's in use.
OK, which way? Yeah. Down this way?
This way.
Drew's after some quality craftsmanship from Britain's industrial past, and things are already looking promising.
Is that stool in here?
Yes, it is, yes, behind us.
Marvellous.
There's another deluxe upholstered one.
It's this one. You'll let this one go. It's not being used.
Right.
Somebody shoved rubber in there, or leather.
Yes.
To stop it moving, which is actually not a bad idea.
It's modified, that one.
Modified. Is that, yes. I mean, it's more money. That is going in the listing. That's it for me. I've been the patina of 1,000 arses.
Yeah.
Brilliant. The big thing with Singer stools is making sure that there's no cracks in the cast iron base. Seat's good, winds up and down, but there is no wing nut on it, so Carl's going to have to find a wing nut. Well, the last one I bought of these, I only bought it a few days ago, and I paid 75 quid for it. I think that was right, yeah? Is that right?
Yeah, in
the front. Right, well, that sounds all right.
Is that all right to you?
Yes.
Marvellous. Thank you very much. Price for the stool, £75. A decent turn in it for us. It has to be a perfect finished product. You're taking a piece of industrial furniture and then putting it in somebody's house who potentially has got white walls and white carpets, so it has to be absolutely spotless. Would you sell any of these?
Yes.
You would?
Yeah, it'd be open to offers.
I can't remember the last time I saw 1940s and 50s factory furniture still being used every day. Now, these are great for my clientele. Just what we're after. All of a sudden, this factory furniture is now fashionable and people want it.
These five-tiered boot racks are probably from the 1940s and are well-worn from continuous use. The timber shelves set in a steel frame, colour and markings are the calling cards of industrial salvage. As they're also authentic factory pieces, they could be worth around £350.
It's got a bit of damage to it, but I can live with it. How about 125 quid?
Again, that sounds reasonable to me.
Sold a scene.
That's another good deal on a piece of industrial history. But Drew's always got one eye on a potential package.
Can I have a look at the other one as well?
Yeah,
should
sure.
Should we do a deal on both?
Yeah.
125 again. So £250 a pair?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Sure?
Yeah, sounds,
sure?
Yeah, sounds good.
Well, just deal.
They only sell pairs here.
You're welcome.
They only sell pairs here.
He's there again.
Drew's really finding his feet with two deals done so far.
I think I've got a shoe sniffing fetish then.
But there are still plenty of other corners to search for more industrial items.
Oh, lovely old building. Right. So I can see this is just a dumping ground of stuff.
It is, yes. We bring all the old machines to die.
Can I have a look through here?
Yeah, sure.
Thousands of shoe lasts.
Yes.
Thousands of them. So what else have we got in here then? Steel toe caps, box full of steel toe caps. Oh, I love it in here. How do I get up there? It's their dumping ground and it's fantastic. I love places like this. They've literally, you can see somebody stood at the door and just done that and just sort of hooked something in. I think he said 15 to 20 years, nobody's been even just in that corner of the shed. I love it. Just all sorts of great stuff. got a few of these.
Some of the old light fittings?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you want rid of them?
Yes. Yeah, then. Not doing anything in here.
Made in the UK by a company called Revo.
Right. With
great quality. There you go, look.
Yeah.
Super quality. These are in really nice nick, actually. See? You got one.
Three.
There's another one over there. One, two, three, four.
Yeah, there's one leaning up there, I think, as well, behind you.
If there's more of them.
Oh, hang on, there's one right in front of me there.
Yeah.
Age-wise, we're looking any time from 1950 to 60, and they're in remarkable nick, because they haven't been in, like, a welding factory or a paint factory or something that's going to get them splattered with rubbish. They're really, really amazing original condition. They really are.
Revo were a West Midlands-based lighting company founded in the early 20th century. They became known for their high-quality industrial and street lighting, often with an iconic green shade. The company no longer exists, but their products are still sought-after items thanks to their durability and industrial design. This set of seven factory tube lights are in great condition, and with their original ceiling hooks, they could be worth around £175 each.
How much would you want each? I'll just take them all. I'll buy all of them.
£30.
I was going to say £25 to make it easier.
£25
a pup.
Yeah.
Take them all.
Boom.
Marvellous.
With a final deal done on the lights, Drew's got a great selection of quality items from one of Britain's traditional manufacturers.
Today was great, really enjoyable. Got to view this absolutely fantastic little factory. It's just brilliant. I mean, look at all the stuff. The shoe racks we bought today, I think, was definitely the purchase of the day. They will fly out. You can pile anything on those. The little singer stool I bought, they're a design classic, bit of an icon in the sort of architectural industrial furniture. A simple piece of industrial design, made to do a job, and it's still doing it, sometimes nearly 100 years later.
It's been a good fun day, I think, to have Drew to come and see what we class as our Monday to Friday work and see somebody take so much interest in our place. It's quite, quite humbling.
I just think that's a wonderful thing. It's a British company. They've been going over 100 years. I think we did well there.
Yeah.
Do you know what I liked about that place?
Everything.
It had soul. I've been waiting to use that all day.
Put your foot in it now.